nervous, and we're going to get around there. Every brother, this month, every brother, so y'all might as well write it down, Father's Day, next Sunday. I'll be gone on Wednesday night. Amen. Y'all going to have plenty of time. But I really like what Brother Terrence shared. You can feel that evangelistic spirit, that leading that he has. We just thank God that God is still speaking. Okay, Brother Travis, amen. I'm going to give you 5 minutes. Because we don't want Brother Wayne to go over 12:30. That's what we got. All right, so Brother Travis, just try to, now if you don't get it all out, you can have as much time as you can walk Wednesday night, right?
Thank you, Pastor. Good morning, sisters and brothers. I want to talk to you about my faith walk. Faith is probably the most powerful tool that we have, that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ made available to us. And to, but it's up to us to build on it and use it for our life, for our spiritual walk, and for everything else that we need. I'll tell you a little quick story. Convention offside a few years ago. The only faith I had was the faith that I had in myself. And that's a faith that I relied on for about 40 years. But it was a faith that wasn't producing anything in my life except trials and tribulations, day in and day out, living from day to day, life and death situations pretty much every day of my life. I had no hope. Life was only what I saw that day, and the next day didn't matter because I never expected to see the next day. But when I came through these doors several years ago, all of that changed. God has a way of using people, put people in your path when you're not hearing him. And believe me, I wasn't hearing him. And God put a wonderful person, Paulette, in my path. That started everything in my Christian walk. I needed somebody that I could trust, could talk to, and he gave me that person. You know, just like God used Moses to reach his people, he used Paulette to reach me. Now, after being here for about a year or so, you know, Paulette was going to back to Sunday school. You know, and I would just sit on the pew, you know, pray and read my Bible. And when they would come out, you know, I would watch them, you know, and they would be happy, laughing and talking. And so one day I think Pastor Hill, somebody said, you know, you should go back there. So the next Sunday I did. And I tell you, Brother Donnell, you know, he has a lot of insight. He's anointed. And he teaches the word, and he makes you feel comfortable in learning. He makes it fun. You know, if I had a Sunday school teacher like him when I was growing up in Midland, Texas, I wouldn't have dropped out of Sunday school at age 10. So he gives, you know, through him, through our pastors James and Pastor Merlin Hill, my faith was what's got me to where I am today. When I gave my life to Christ on that Easter Sunday, God did a miracle in my life. He changed me from a thug to a dove. Everything that I asked him to do, He did it. But that wouldn't have happened if I didn't believe that that would happen. It's not because I wanted it so bad, because I needed it that bad. And I needed to believe that it would happen. So I had to make a turn in my life. I had to stop doing things for myself, trying to make things happen in my own strength. And I finally had to lay everything at God's feet. Jesus Christ did everything that I asked him to do. And because of that, ever since that day, I've had to, and I enjoy relying on my faith. I don't mind asking God for what I want. I don't mind asking him for what I need, because I know if I don't get it right then, I'm going to get it eventually. See, in my faith walk, I had to learn patience. In my faith walk, I had to learn accepting Jesus. All, the whole Jesus, everything about him, I had to receive and accept it. So I had to be everything that I saw in him. I had to live that for myself. Through the years, you know, especially after losing Paulette, you know, of course my world turned upside down. But if it wasn't for my faith in Jesus Christ, I wouldn't have made it. I wouldn't be here today. I would probably be back doing what I was doing before. But I knew better, and I'm strong enough in who I am, and knowing who I am and who I am in Christ, that going back to what I was wasn't an option, and it wasn't necessary. Because I realized that whatever I had gone through, that I could get through it. And God got me through everything that I needed to get through. Now, I've had some challenges here this past year. I've had to deal with some giants. And I just want to share in Matthew 17:20. So Jesus said to them, because of your unbelief, for as surely as I say to you, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. That passage is everything that I've gone through in the past several months. Without faith, I would not have been able to move the mountains that I've had to move. And these mountains come in all forms and all shapes and all kinds. And the longer I have to deal with moving with the drug addiction, alcohol addiction, and all of those addictions, that mountain was moved on that day I gave my life to Christ. But the devil, being who he is and doing what he's supposed to do, he'll continue to move mountains in your way. Yes. But it's your faith will determine